This is the Widex Allure ITE RD, and it is quite possibly, no, I've changed that, it is definitely the most advanced in-ear hearing aid that Widex have ever made. So, let's break this down. Widex are the Danish giants who've been around since the late 1950s. Allure is their latest generation of hearing aid platform built on their new W1 chip. ITE stands for in-ear, meaning that in terms of size, you're looking at something similar to this. We're not talking about a hearing aid that's built for cosmetics here. We're talking a fully loaded earbud-style hearing aid designed to hide in plain sight. R stands for rechargeable, with this new hearing aid lasting up to 23 hours from a single 4-hour charge. And then finally, the D stands for direct streaming, meaning direct LE audio connectivity with your smartphone. So, let's break this all down. Not long ago now, in fact, specifically on April the 15th, 2025 at 4:23, I reviewed the Widex Allure RIC RD, their receiver and canal counterpart hearing aid that launched Widex's brand new W1 chip and precision hearing aid technology. And there is no question that it was a long needed leap forwards in terms of technology for Widex. But the question that everybody kept asking was, when will there be a custom in-ear version? Well, I'm delighted to share that Widex have listened, and this is it. The Allure ITE RD integrates everything from the Allure RIC lineup into a discrete, rechargeable, and Bluetooth connected in-the-ear design. And that seems like the best place for us to start today. So kicking off with design, this hearing aid is custom made from a 3D scan or an impression of your ear. And so, therefore, it should sit snugly and comfortably within your ear canal. And crucially, it's built for any of you out there who want all of the benefits of a behind-the-ear hearing aid without having to have anything sat behind your ear. Color-wise, you can choose from black, brown, dark brown, or beige. And based on the popularity of this style from other hearing aid manufacturers, I personally think that most people will choose black so that it's hidden in plain sight and looks like a cool set of earbuds. The charger itself is USB-C powered, it's sleek, magnetic, and definitely has a quality feel to it. Simply drop the hearing aids in and then the charging begins automatically. Couple of thoughts though. They've definitely stolen the design from their sister company, Signia, and if you're planning on traveling with it, make sure that you book its own suitcase in the hold just to take it, as it's quite big to say the least. On the faceplate here, you'll see twin mics for directional hearing and therefore better hearing in noise. Then there's this nice, large, easy to find programmable button, which is a soft key and can be altered by your audiologist so that you can change the program, volume, or even answer phone calls directly from your ears, which is a nice to have, but pretty standard in all hearing aids. Now, before I move on to some of the biggest updates, I've got a cheeky request. You will be surprised to hear that 75% of people watching my video, so 75% of you haven't yet hit the subscribe button. So if I can ask a huge favor from you, if you've ever enjoyed my videos, then please press subscribe. It helps me more than I can say, and it helps me to grow the channel. And the bigger the channel gets, the better my videos will get. Thank you, and I hope you enjoy the rest of today's video. But of course, what makes Allure Allure is what's going on inside. This is all powered by Widex's W1 chip, which is the same next generation processor that made their RIC Widex's most natural sounding hearing aids to date. And we've seen 5 key developments to make this happen. Kicking off, we have their new Widex Allure PureSound feature, which is built on their hallmark PureSound processing technology. And from your perspective, it's designed to provide the most natural and transparent sound experience possible, especially, and this is what Widex is boasting, especially for first-time users and those with a mild to moderate hearing loss. Now, the key foundation for its success is that it uses Widex's ultra-fast zero-delay technology, which processes sound with virtually no delay whatsoever. And this is a big deal. In fact, it's, the quickest in the industry. So for those of you that like numbers, it's 0.5 milliseconds. And Widex are claiming that this eliminates the common echoey or metallic sensation that can occur when amplified sound overlaps with the natural sound entering one's ear canal, particularly with open fitting configurations. With Widex's research showing that it is second to none compared to any other hearing aid manufacturer. Now, In my opinion, the downside of Widex's previous version of this feature was that in order to reduce the delay, Widex had to strip back the noise reduction features built into these hearing aids, meaning that yes, it did sound natural, but there was a lot of sound for you to deal with. However, they're boasting that with this new development, the noise reduction features are back, with the Allure PureSound processing now delivering significantly enhanced speech intelligibility and noise with an improvement of around 4.3 signal to noise ratio. But that's not all. Their second major development is their Speech Enhancer Pro feature. At its core, it's designed to make conversations clearer, especially in noisy environments, without making everything else sound unnatural or robotic. So how exactly does this work? Think of it like this. Imagine you're in a busy cafe trying to hear your friends speak. There's music, people chatting, plates clinking, it's chaotic. Widex is stating that their Speech Enhancer Pro uses an ultra-detailed analysis system, breaking sound down into 52 individual frequency bands. This is then used to scan the environment and figure out what's speech and what's background noise and separating those sounds in real time. And then once it's identified the speech, it channels that information into a 15-band processing system of which the speech is then appropriately delivered to you according to your specific hearing loss. Now, Widex's research has shown that 92% of users, that's huge, 92% of users preferred Speech Enhancer Pro in noisy situations compared to their previous hearing aid technology. And 96% of users said that it successfully reduced annoying background noise in a variety of listening situations. Now, I'll be honest, these are big numbers now, which means that these hearing aids are a huge improvement on their previous hearing aid technology, or their previous hearing aids left a lot of room for improvement. Every time I catch up with the Widex team, they ask me what they can do to improve their hearing aid technology for me to recommend them to more hearing aid users. And every time I always say, please, can you do something to improve your feedback management system? Every single time. Now, in the past, I've been told that they can't do anything without compromising their natural sound philosophy. And I get it, that should always be a priority, focusing on natural sound coming through the hearing aids. But at the same time, if the hearing aids are prone to feedback and whistling, it doesn't matter how natural they sound because patients won't want to wear them. Well, I'm delighted to share that I've tried this new technology and they have definitely improved their feedback system. There is no question about that whatsoever. And they've done so using adaptive frequency shifting, which is constantly calibrating the system multiple times per second, meaning less annoying whistling hearing aids for you. All I'll say is, thank you, Widex. Development number four is their new enhanced sound classification, which includes a beat detector for more precision with its categorization of music. Now, this feature allows the Allures to automatically identify the acoustic environment around you and make a far more accurate decision on the most appropriate way to deliver you sound. They will therefore categorize the world of sound around you according to these 11 environments, five involving speech, and six without, including classic music, contemporary music, party with speech, party without speech, quiet with speech, quiet without speech, transport with speech, transport without speech, urban with speech, urban without speech. In my opinion, this is great for those of you keen to put your hearing aids in the morning, forget about them, and then take them out when you go to bed of an evening, without wanting to necessarily make any adjustments to the settings throughout the day and have to fiddle around pressing buttons or adjusting things on the app. Well done, Widex. Now, the fifth and the final key feature in Widex's precision hearing aid technology lineup is their dedicated streaming processor, which is an improvement that you won't appreciate the benefit of until you actually get to try it. So here's the deal. Up until now, the compression for streaming audio and the microphone input was always tied together. And I think this is the case for most manufacturers too. So if you were, let's say, watching a video or taking a call in a restaurant, with every loud environmental sound, the external noise would also affect your streaming volume too. And that would cause it to spike or to dip, which is obviously not ideal. With this new system, the streaming of audio and microphone input are compressed separately, which means the sounds around you no longer mess with your streaming experience. You'll get consistent, high-quality sound, whether you're in a quiet room or amongst a noisy crowd. As far as connectivity goes, like I mentioned earlier, this technology supports these same features as their behind-the-ear counterparts. counterparts, supporting Bluetooth LE audio so that you can stream music, calls, and the radio or podcasts directly from your iPhone or your Android devices hands-free, with any sound being produced by your hearing aids compensating for your hearing loss too. And not only that, but they're also Auracast ready, meaning that they're ready for the next generation of shared wireless audio, so that one day soon you could walk into the cinema, airport or concert hall and connect directly to the sound system with your hearing aids. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm just bored of hearing myself say that. All hearing manufacturers are sharing the same information and all of them are saying they're Auracast ready. And I'll be honest, Widex, I'll be honest, any other hearing aid manufacturer, I don't want you to be Auracast ready. I want you to be Auracast live. And I'm thinking of starting a free Auracast campaign. I don't know what you hearing aid users think about that. Would you be on board? Shall I do something like that? Let me know in the comments. Widex, stop making Auracast ready. Make it Auracast live. Let's get this sorted so people can use it. Anyway, back to Widex's developments. Yes, you will also have direct Apple Watch control. And yes, due to the direct streaming nature of this tech, you can utilize great accessories such as the Widex TV Play and their app, but annoyingly not their best accessory, which is the Sound Assist, which is a bit of a turn off, Widex, something else to get sorted out. This is your newest accessory and it's the best thing that you've got out there. It doesn't make sense that it only works with older technology. Now, I've got to tell you that I don't think you should buy these hearing aids. Well, okay, calm down, Widex. Not yet anyway. Not until you've compared them to every other hearing aid that's out there. You could buy these hearing aids, I'm only joking.